Hello again. Today we're going to be making this winter-themed picture of a little bird feeder with a cardinal on it. So I've already got the sketch laid out, and we're going to start by lowering the opacity on our sketch layer. We're going to create a new layer, and this we're going to fill with this light blue color. So there we go. Move our sketch layer on top so we can still see. So I'm gonna add. I like this kind of light gray, just an off-white color. And I am gonna take my marker tool, if I can find it. There we go. And we're just gonna add in some lighter areas. That's very vibrant. I want that a little lighter. Up the opacity, get more of the color. Want it to look like clouds in the background. So I'm taking my blending tool. I've made a very big brush because I want to have big strokes. Right, this is just the background. Want it to have some varied layers. There we go. So I'm gonna add those back in again. This time I'm gonna make it a little bit smaller. Just kind of drag that color around. Right, this background isn't supposed to be in focus, so the less details we have in it, the more that front image is gonna pop. Just one more time. Maybe a little bit smaller brush. Just adding some dots. There we go. Reduce this as well. That's a little too small. And just drawing little circles. Now we've got some wispy clouds with some different layers in the background. Awesome. Well done. We're off to a good start. So next we're going to do the bird feeder. So we're going to make a new layer. I'm going to use the rectangle selection tool. And there we go. It's about where I want it. It is a little bit off from what I drew, but that's okay. So let's start with like a dark brown color. We're just gonna fill it in. This is just to help us see where that square is, where that boundary is. And now we're gonna add some small marks. Bring my pen tool back. Bring down the size of our marker. And we're just gonna make little boop boop boops. Little small lines in some different colors of brown and yellow. Maybe a little green to help him pop. So our bird's gonna be red, and the contrasting color to red is green. And when you put them next to each other, it makes it more vibrant. So it'll appear more red. It'll help them stand out a little bit more. So we're just gonna go around. I've used a slightly darker color, brown. Just filling our bird feeder up with some bird seed. Let's go with this. Let's up the opacity, see if that looks a little more different. Here we go. I don't think I want it at 100%, but this one I'm gonna do more as dots. And if you buy bird seed, there's a mix of different things in it. This is actually inspired by a bird feeder that I have in my backyard. Although it is not currently filled with bird seed. They ate it all. Sometimes we do get cardinals in the back. They just look so pretty. Alright, let's do this. There's not much contrast between that one and the other one. So I'm gonna go over to my color wheel. Do I wanna add here like this, but I'm gonna make it a little bit lighter. That stands out a little too much. There we go. So I upped the opacity to 100, and I went down a little bit into some of this grayer tones. That way it matches the rest a little bit better. Want this one to look like little corn kernels. Just going around. There, that looks really nice. Alright, I said we were gonna add some green, so let's go with a yellowy green. But again, we're gonna come down into this slightly grayer area, and I'm gonna reduce the opacity on this a little bit to help it to. Oh, nope, that makes it stand out more. Interesting. There we go. Maybe these could be like little peas. Those are good for birds, I think. Try not to cluster them too much. Just where it looks good. We picked it in the darker kind of green. The darker tint. Stay in the same value range, otherwise it's going to be the one to stand out. We don't want that. That looks good. Nicely done. I'm just gonna add some, so I missed this edge there. Good to catch it now. These other colors. It looks layered. Nicely done. I do want it to look out of focus, so let's start with the gouache and blur. Then maybe come back in with the blending tool. Making small little strokes. I do like how it looks. Don't want the colors going too far. Let's do it a little smaller, just kind of make a full bird feeder. Here we go. Alright, let's add a new layer, and I want to clip it to the one below, that way we're only coloring on top of it, but I've still got my little selected area too. That's alright. And this layer I want to do as I'm going to take that off-white, that light gray. Ooh, that is exactly what I was hoping for. I'm going to reduce the opacity. So I want it to be brighter. Towards the edge, and then a little bit dulled as we get towards the middle, like loosen it. You can't see it quite as well. Oops. Bring it up again. take that blending tool. And I'm not gonna touch the edges, the sides of it, just towards the middle. There we go. Blend this out just a little. Looks nice. Well done. All right, so we're going to make a new layer. Good job. And we're going to do this is the polyline tool to do the outside, like the top and then the bottom of the bird feeder. I like this forest green color that we had before. I think that's gonna look really pretty. Make a bigger brush size. My opacity up. I am going to color this whole shape, even though we are going to come back in and cover it with snow. And then let's see, I'm going to take some of this. No, that doesn't look quite right. Okay, let's go back here for a second. Bring it down. Adding a little bit of a shadow. And blending it just a little. And we are gonna add, I'm gonna go back to this color and then there we go. Just put a tiny little bit of like a yellowy green, and then kind of blend that. Give it a little bit of a highlight. Nicely done. And then we're going to go back to our polyline tool. Make a similar shape down on the bottom and use those same colors that we just used. So this foresty green color. Is this the same one? This one. Hold on. Nope, that's not the right color. Select, reselect. Alright, figured it out. And this was our shadow color. And whoops. Going awry. Up to the bottom. And then on the side of our little bird, and I'm gonna come back in and color on top. There we go. you guessed it. We're gonna soften that edge just a little. And I do want to bring it back. Oops. Wrong color. There, where their bird friend is. Nicely done. Oh, we didn't add shadows on our bird feeder. So let's go back to the soft light layer. We're going to deselect the area. This is clipped to the one below it, so we don't have to worry about drawing somewhere we shouldn't. I'm going to keep this same dark green color that we were just using. And there we go. That looks really nice. Can I make it just a little bit darker? No, that's not quite right. Do apologize, I've never used this filter before. Some lines like a shadow on the side. If you see this little arrow, this is so I know where the light is coming from. That way I'm consistent with it throughout the image. So I'm gonna add, we've added a shadow underneath here, and we're adding one on this side as well. And this one, oh, that's the eraser tool. I'm gonna hit the blending tool. Blend that out just a little bit. A little bit of softness there. Oh, I like that very much. Nicely done. Alright, we're gonna come back here. That way our layer goes on top of it, and add a new layer. This is going to be our snow layer. So I'm going to use the lasso tool. And just make kind of a blobby shape for the snow on top. Oh, sorry, I keep moving this around. So I'm gonna fill it all in with this white. That way we can see the whole area a little better. But then if you look at snow, it's not really white. It's blues and yellows and orange and purple. It's so pretty. So we're gonna add some blue. I'm gonna add some. Some nice light warm colors on this side because this is where the sun is coming from. right on the edge there. Alright, and we're gonna blend these out a little. That way it's not as abstract. I think I'm gonna add just a little bit more of that white as we're blending. The colors don't get so muddy. Oh, it's pulling in the green from below it. Just pulling in that green color. I don't want that in my snow. Add in a little bit more of the shadow. It wouldn't be so dark on the side. Oh, sorry, I'm whispering. So we're just adding in a little bit more of a shadow underneath, along the bottom edge of the snow. And then you can see I switched to the lighter blue, because the shadow wouldn't be as dark in the area closer to the light. That's interesting that you can see this through it. As we blended it. Alright. So going to erase. Let's see what it looks like. Nice. Much better. Oops, I'm on the wrong layer. That happens frequently. I think I want one shade darker. Really push the values there. Wonderful. Alright, we're going to create a new layer and use our lasso selection tool. So we're gonna start by drawing like a rounded triangle, and then an oval. Alright, then we'll use the selection pen. And we're gonna draw like a big triangle for the tail feathers. And we're gonna fill in the whole thing. There we go. So we're going to come back to this marker tool. And I don't have a red selected that I like, so we're going to look for a second. The cardinals are a really pretty deep red. I wouldn't go into the orange range. I would stay away from these darker ones. So make sure we're on the right layer. And we're just going to fill in our selected area. Nicely done. Oh, he's looking so good. So we're gonna add a little bit of details. So we are gonna come down into some of these tints, this darker area. Remember, our light's coming from this way. So we're gonna add a little bit of shadow behind his head. We're gonna make the brush a little bit smaller and add in the outline for this wing. I'm gonna add some shadows along his back. And then I can switch to a slightly smaller brush. Add some little like check marks for the wings. And then draw some lines for his tail feathers. Then again, we're going to use the blending tool. Soften up this edge. Go along and make it smaller. What about blur? What does that do? Oh, I like that. So we've switched to the blur tool and we're following along these lines that we drew. The same thing for his wing. Then we're going to add one more tone. Oops. Here we go. Just a slightly darker. Oh, I like that color a lot. Just in the middle. Then I'm going to make my brush really small. Add this finer line along the feather. I don't necessarily want it to go the whole length, just to be something to make it pop a little bit, give it a little bit of contrast. And we're going to do the same for his wing up here. And these little feather lines. Here we go. So we're going to come back to our blur tool. Oh, I'm on the wrong layer again. There we go. Right along the feathers. There, and then we're going to switch back to the blending tool. That's way too big. Blend out those little shadows. Nicely done. He's looking really handsome. I'm going to use this along some of the harder edges of the feather. Drag the colors a little bit. Nicely done. Great. We're gonna do another new layer. I'm gonna clip this, but we've got the area selected anyway. And I want this to have a little bit more texture. So I'm gonna select colored pencil and I'm gonna go back to that. Oh, I'm still on it. Perfect. That dark red, almost black color, because they've got, can I make this a little bit bigger? triangle on their face. Then that. If I do a real pencil, I need some fun texture. No, I don't like that as much. Let's go back to the colored pencil. I don't want too big. Back to the marker for a second. Blend that out just a little bit. Good job. Alright, we're gonna deselect our selected area. Make one new layer. Then use our lasso tool again. I'm gonna zoom in. Draw a little triangle for his beak. And I've got like an orange. Not too bright. Use our marker tool. Color that in. Then add a little bit. Oh, of a shadow. It's a little too dark. Under. Add a little line. The middle. Select our selected area. And I'll just clean that up a little bit with my eraser. And marker, just to even that out. And give them a little eye. They look beady. It's really small. Let's try to dull it a little. Beautiful. Bring that white back. Give it a little sparkle. He's looking good. Oh, I wanted to add little perches on it. Good thing we got that. So let's come back to the same layer that our. The top and bottom of our bird feeder is on, and we're going to use our selection tool, rectangle, and then we're gonna fill this in with like a dark green. Let me put my brush size. and paste it. So now we've got copied over here. So we can move that to the other side. That looks about even. Let's do another one. Copy number two. Put that right in the middle. Copy number four. Three. Oh. You know, math is not my strong suit. That one there. And then let's do something like that. We're going to merge these layers. There we go, now it's all on the same one. We're going to use our marker tool. Come in. Just round out the side. On each one. Clean that up. Nice. Let's do a dark, dark one, and we'll make a small, small thing on the marker. And just add a tiny little shadow on the bottom. Nice thing about digital art is that undo button. It's your best friend. There we go, looks good. Alright, let's hide our sketch layer. Do some touch-ups. Comes in here. Oh, go on the wrong layer. Always good to double check. We didn't see. It looks a little bit off to me. Let's try adding the primary theme on this side. There, that looks nice. And I just add that line. They look so cute. One final detail. Let's go back to that dark green. We'll add I see our snow. It's a little left is design and save. Alright, thank you for painting with me today. I hope you had fun. I know I did. And hopefully I'll see you again soon.